So good morning children, today we are going to study grammar, okay. Today we are going to study tense, which we can say that this is the part of our syllabus for class 9th standard also for CBSE, class 10th standard also for CBSE, for class 9th standard ICSE, for class 10th standard ICSE board. So we can say that the tense is very much important in the grammar section in our syllabus from the point of view of examination, okay, and in the daily use also, right. So maybe children, you all have studied tense many time or the first time you are going to study, but today we will try to study tense in the simplest and easiest method, okay. So you can write past here also, okay, no issue is there, and present there also, or simply you can write present here also and past there also. So actually children, what we have to understand, right? That past, present and future, these are time, okay. So what we are experiencing, that is called present time, right. What we had experienced, that is called past time, and what we are expecting, which we may experience, that is called future time. So time can be divided in three groups, we can say three categories, we can say, and they are past, present and future. They are past, present and future. This we are discussing about kinds of time, right. Now if I ask that how we can divide the tense, they are the four kinds: simple, continuous, perfect and perfect continuous. Simple, continuous, perfect and perfect continuous. So total, if we study the number of tenses, how much it will become? 12 into 3, okay, 4 into 3, 12. So what we have to do, we have to make some boxes like this. So I know that some of you may get confused in the beginning that what I am saying, that time is of three kind and tense is of four kind, right. But I believe that at the end of this session, you will be also having the confidence that what I am teaching is the easiest and the most correct method of studying tense. And the most correct method of studying tense. Thank you. So, past, present and future, I am saying these three are the kinds of time. And I am saying simple, continuous, perfect and perfect continuous, these four are the kinds of tense. These four are the kinds of tense. Okay. See, when we talk about simple tense, what we mean, children, means we are talking about something which is habitual, which used to happen regularly, which used to happen continuously. If you talk about simple past tense, it was happening in the past. If you talk about simple present tense, it is still happening in the present. If you talk about simple future tense, this may happen. Means whenever it will happen, it will be habitual. Right? So when we talk about continuous tense, what we mean? We mean, we don't know when the work is started. We don't know when the work will finish. Only we know at the time of speaking, the work is in progress. The work is continuous. Right? So now if I talk about past continuous tense, what I mean? I'm talking that in the past, the work was in the progressive form, the work was in the continuous form. Okay. When I talk about present tense, means at the time of speaking, the work is in progress. When I talk about future tense, I mean at a particular time, the work will be in progress. So what we can say, children, that continuous tense is speaking that at a particular instant, the work is in progress. Example also we can see, like I am speaking. So at a particular instant, the work is in progress, I am speaking. I was speaking. So in the past, at a particular instant, the work was in progress, I was speaking. I will be speaking. So in future, at a particular moment, at a particular instant, the work will be in progress, I will be speaking. Okay. So many books if you study, okay, if you study some of the good books which are written on English grammar, you are able to find out that much confusion is there related to time and tense. And no question in the examination they will ask that what is time, what is tense. They will only ask you to solve the exercise. If you are able to solve the exercise, your definition is correct. Right? Your definition is correct. So what I am teaching you, that you have to understand past is time, past time, present time, future time. And these four are the tenses. This tense is speaking that something which used to happen habitual, something which used to happen at the particular instant, something where the work is completed, right? At the time of speaking or in the past at a particular instant, the work is completed. Perfect continuous means we know when the work is started and we know when the work ended, right? So like this, we can understand they all four are the tenses. And when these tenses are swinging in time, then we are getting simple past tense, past continuous tense, past perfect tense and past perfect continuous tense. Then simple present tense, present continuous tense, present perfect tense and present perfect continuous tense. Simple future tense, future continuous tense, future perfect tense and future perfect continuous tense. So this is the simplest method of studying tense. Okay. If you go to any university also, children, okay, I'm talking about the foreign university, the top ranking university, and if there also someone is teaching tense, they are teaching the tense in this manner only, the most simplest way and the most correct way. For example, now I am writing the structure formula for the affirmative sentences, right? I'm writing the structure formula for all the affirmative sentences simply. Like, he went to school. He went to school. Subject plus we do plus subject. I don't encourage any child to remember the structure formula also. I only ask you that you remember one sentence. That simple past tense, one example is there, he went to school. Now you can relate some other sentences, and with the help of the practice, you can make the sentences always correct. like the present tense, what we can write that he So, simple present tense, subject plus V1 oblique V5 plus object, he goes to school or you go to school. So, V1 or V5. And what is V5? Adding S or ES in the verb is called V5. When we are doing this? When the subject is in the singular form. So, children, if you know that you can make the simple present tense, then all the similar simple present tenses of affirmative sentences, I hope that you can make correctly. Okay, so the future tense, like he will go to the school. So what I am asking you, you remember one example, simple future tense, one example. Okay, he will go to school. Now like this we can make so many other sentences. They will learn to study. Okay, he will learn to read the newspaper. So many similar sentences we can write. This can help us in writing our story. This can help us in writing the letter. This can help us in writing the unseen passage. Right? And this can help us to do the grammar exercise also, where we have to fill the correct use of the verb in the bracket. We have to find out the error. So we can understand, children, okay? Tense is very much easy if we are able to study the tense in the simplest and most correct method. So like this, all the structure formula can be written. So subject plus was oblique where plus V4 plus object. So here one example we can write, he was going to school. Now in the present tense, auxiliary verb is changed with is, am, are, right? He is going to school. So why I am teaching in this manner? I am teaching in this manner that you study simple tense, all past, present, future will be completed. Like you can see the similarity. He went to school, he goes to school, he will go to school. Here second form of the verb is used. Here first or fifth form of the verb is used. No auxiliary verb here, okay? Here also no auxiliary verb. Here shall or will is used, which are the auxiliary verb. So like this we can understand, okay? If I am teaching continuous tense, so here subject plus was oblique where plus V4 plus object. Continuous tense always having the ing form of the verb. Ing form of the verb means V4, okay? Progressive, continuous. So subject plus was oblique where plus V4 plus object, same structure formula we can see in the present tense. Only the change is of auxiliary verb. So subject plus is oblique am oblique are plus V4 plus object. He was going to school. This is the past continuous tense. Present continuous tense, he is going to school. Very easy. Then so he will be going to the school. What is the structure formula of future continuous tense? Subject plus shall oblique will plus be plus V4 plus object. What is same? Subject plus V4 plus object is same in all the continuous tenses. What is changing? Auxiliary verb is changing. Here was and were in the past, present is, am, are, future shall oblique will plus be. So we can learn grammar in the most correct way and most easy manner. Okay. Now the third one, we are going to study about the perfect tense. And the perfect tense used to say that the work is completed or work was completed or work will have been completed. Okay. So here the structure formula is subject plus had plus past participle V3 plus object. Like he had gone to school. So in the present perfect tense, what will come? Subject plus has oblique have plus V3 plus object. Like he has gone to school. And children, at last I will discuss with you that why I am teaching in this manner. I am teaching in this manner because in the examination, this only used to be the question that in the blank what will come? Had is there, so what we have to use? Has is there, what we have to use? Or in the blank, had we will put or has we will put. So the confusion is here only. We are knowing that the perfect tenses are there, but which perfect tense we have to use, that is the confusion. Okay. So subject plus has oblique have plus V3 plus object is the example of present perfect tense. This is the affirmative sentences. Then future perfect tense will have, or we can say shall have also, plus V3 plus object. Like they shall have gone to school. Or all the sentences we are using of he, so here also we can use he only. Okay, he shall have gone to school. Then past perfect continuous tense, subject plus had plus been plus V4 plus object plus since oblique 4 plus object dash or point of time, right? Like he had been going to school for 3 years. So simply we have taken one example that he had been going to school for 3 years. Then in the present, subject plus has oblique have plus been plus V4 plus object plus since oblique 4 plus object dash or point of time. Okay. So example we can write, he has been going, he has been going to school for 3 years. And in the future, subject plus has, will have been. Okay, so here will or shall will be used. Subject plus will oblique shall plus have plus been plus V4 plus object plus 4 oblique from. Right. Example we can write that I will have been learning engineering from 2022. So children, now we will analyze, right, why the tense is important, what is the use of the tense, how we can do the minimum mistakes, or I will suggest not to do any mistake only. There should not be any mistake only how we can study in that manner, right? So first of all, in any examination, you talk about CBSE 9th standard, CBSE 10th standard, ICSE 9th standard, ICSE 10th standard. In any examination, definition from the grammar section is not coming, right? But we have to know the correct definition also. What is coming? Coming is the writing section. You should be good in writing the story. You should be good in writing the letter, article, email. Okay, notice. So you should be good in writing section and you should be good in grammar. So that things how we can do when we are able to write the sentences correctly first of all. Example, simple sentence if it is, then he went to school. Then he goes to school. When I am talking about past, then went. When I am talking about present, goes. When I will talk about future, he will go to school. This is the sequence. Like, he was going to school, it is in the past tense. He is going to school, it is in the present tense. He will be going to the school, it is in the future tense. And here what we are using, was and were, they are the auxiliary verb. Is, am, are, they are the auxiliary verb. Shall and will, they are the auxiliary verb. So by changing the auxiliary verb only, we have changed the tense. What we have done? We have changed the tense. So this type, if we study, children, no, there is no chances of doing mistake in the paper, either in the writing section or in the grammar section, right? Like you see perfect tense, he had gone to school, he has gone to school, then he shall have gone to school. Nearly all the structure formula are same except this had, has and shall have. And in the grammar question, this much only used to be the difference in the child who is opting the right answer and the child who is opting the wrong answer. We have to understand, right? Subject plus had plus vidhi plus object, it is the past. Had is used. Subject plus has plus have plus vidhi plus object, it is present. Subject plus will obli have plus shall plus have plus vidhi plus object, it is the future. And I suggest all of you also that not to remember the structure formula also. So one example also, if you are knowing from that also, you can remember the structure formula. Some more thing we can see here, been is used. And in the see, if I talk right here, the form of verb also, children, you can see V1 or V5 is used in the simple continuous, V4 is used, right? Perfect continuous, what is used? V4 is used. Perfect V3 is used, okay? And only in the simple past tense, V2 is used. So that also we will write, or here I am writing, V2 is used. So there is only one tense in which second form of the verb is used, and 30% question of the grammar they used to come from this section only. Second form of the verb you have to put. Like this, what they are asking the question, okay, he blank and then some related paragraphs are there, here maybe go is written. So you have to write here went, he went to the market, he went to school, okay. So V2 is used in only one tense and the tense is simple past tense. Then V5 is used in only one tense, that is simple present tense. Okay, are you able to understand? Then we will see here V1 we are using. From the verb is the action part. No, from the verb we will try to understand the tense, right? Here V4 we are using. So here I can say no, that all the continuous tenses we are using which form of verb? V4 we are using. All the perfect tenses you can see, children, we are using third form of the verb, V3. Perfect means V3. Perfect means V3. Then last, all the perfect continuous we are using V4. Perfect continuous means V4. Perfect continuous means V4. Perfect continuous means V4. So now how we can summarize this whole board information, right? By some simple methods. First of all, you see in any tense, if the word continuous is coming, we have to use ing form of the verb, we have to use V4. Okay, we have to use ing form of the verb, we have to use V4. Like here you see, continuous, perfect continuous, V4, 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 everywhere V4. So out of 12 tenses, out of 12 tenses, 6 tenses we are using V4 only. And then 3 tenses we are using V3. 9 tenses are there. 1 tenses we are using V2. 10. 1 tenses we are using V5. 11. And 1 tenses we are using V1. 12. This is very hard to understand. No. Where the children used to do mistake? In the forms of the verb, where they have to keep the particular verb. So if it is simple future, V1 will come. If it is a present, a simple present, here V1 can also come and V5 can also come. This much only difference is there. So if it is simple present and simple future, how we will differentiate? Here auxiliary verb is coming, no, shall of the will. So these all things used to make the change. So this is only the introduction of tenses. Okay. And I hope this is the most easiest method of studying tense. So that we cannot do any mistake in the writing section also and in the grammar also. If you know one sentence, you can make the similar sentences in the writing section. And the grammar part also we can do nicely. So I hope in the coming classes, we will discuss deeply about the tenses in detail. And we will see which are the most easy and correct method of studying tense. So thank you children. Have a good day.